your energy. I don't like that. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendencies. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play. All these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy.
Playoff fever has immersed South Florida as we are at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got a great one in store between the Buffalo Bills and the Miami Dolphins. In the AFC Championship game, off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. Fielded just outside the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. One goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Off of play action. Tagovailoa buying time to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. He's got a man complete. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown.
Well, this has been a quick strike offense all season long, finding many different ways to manufacture big plays.
They had a big playoff preview today in the papers, and it was about who would set the tone. Well, they just set the tone right there. Extra point and good by Sanders. And it's now a 7-0 game. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Off the play fake. Allen. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown.
Well, Cindy, we have seen it many times throughout the course of the season. This defense coming up large and snagging a big takeaway. But here they get not just the takeaway, 6 points as well.
And you just knew that for this team to advance, they've delivered.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. So you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
I'm with you on that one. And what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
Defense, defense.
from the 31. Allen steps away to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Allen now looks to throw. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 30 before being taken down. Allen now on first down. He'll get this out wide to Singletary. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Here's Devin Singletary. He played in this state at Florida Atlantic, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mucked that down for a win in the defense's column.
From the 29, Allen. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
They got to get it to the 21 here on third down. To throw, it's Allen. Forced out to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
How about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
And this is just outside the right upright. It's no good. These playoff games have a tendency to be tight, and you have to wonder if that missed field goal could haunt them later.
Yeah, we're always looking for the key plays, right? The ones that we're going to magnify. Usually those happen in the second half or later in the game. This might be the key play of the game showing up here in the first half.
52 blasters. No check. Hey, check negative.
On the ground, it's Mostert to start the drive. And it's a run to run now. And now off to the races, down the right side, and all the way in for a Miami touchdown.
Boy, still in the first quarter, and look out, I mean, they are on pace for over 80 points in this game. I don't know that they'll get there, CD, but this has been impressive to watch so far.
That certainly would be his game of making, wouldn't it, partner? I'm glad we're here to actually watch and see if it actually happens. I have my doubts, but they are firmly in control of this game.
So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They're forced to play catch-up early in this division round game as they search for a seat in the AFC Championship round. Now he dumps this off over the middle and up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
Well, these guys certainly need something good to go their way because this first quarter has been something of a disaster for them trying to move the ball. But that completion there, maybe can get them focused and moving in the right direction.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a gain of 13 and a Buffalo first down.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
Throwing again on second down. Allen. Pass caught. It's Davis on the crossing route. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he'll get this underneath to Singletary. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And the Bills are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive.
And he takes it in across the chalk for a Bills touchdown. Devin Singletary taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Bills are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. Extra point by Bass, up and good, and they'll cut the lead to 21-7. Here's the Bills kickoff unit out as they will send this one away. From the 10. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
This is caught inside the 15. It's a big play there for Miami. 62 yards.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket, because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
A pretty wild first quarter. 21-7, our score. Scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3 for 3 to start. Here's Mostert. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A full 5-yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough. One more time with Mostert. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Raheem Mostert with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the
the Dolphins continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Extra point and goal line Sanders. And a lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Very short kick taken right at the 20. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
Throwing on first down is Allen. Going right back to Knox, and again a completion. And they'll be stopped at the 28 on a play that started at the 14. They pick up 14. Here's Allen on first and 10. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll give him a short yardage situation here for second down. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Now Allen. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Well, that's good decision-making right there. Understood down and distance. Knew it wasn't third down, and he still had another opportunity to earn the first down. Good job throwing it away and avoiding an interception.
Second and 10. Allen. And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Gabriel Davis, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Bills get a bit closer. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that cuts the lead to 28-14. Here's the Bills kickoff unit out as they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Right now, everything they touch turns to gold. This is their fourth possession. Touchdowns on their first three possessions. I mean, this defense, they can't seem to stop them. It's like they're on skates.
Great analogy, Brandon, because they are pushing them back and winning everything at the line of scrimmage. They've just been laying down tracks towards the opposite end zone. So to themselves, all they're saying is, if we don't make a mistake, there's no way they can stop us.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that he had
to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. And it's a room to maneuver. And it's a good acceleration there as he's across midfield to the 48-yard line. 87 yards rushing for him now as he has been strong here in the first half of this divisional round matchup. On first down, they go with Mostert again. And this time, the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. In motion, Hill. From midfield, here's Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend.
Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Early down stuffs will put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
In motion, the tight end. Second down, here's Mostert again. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. He is going to find Hill here. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 35 yards. And the Dolphins take a 3-touchdown lead.
Brandon, what we just saw there were two guys who were in sync. The person delivering the ball, but especially the person running the route. Tremendous job. It results in a terrific play.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This will be fielded inside the 5. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. So already not the best of kick returns there, but that penalty, that adds insult to injury and backs him up even closer to the goal line.
Yeah, not ideal field position to begin a drive, is it? Because the extra pressure now goes on the offense. They've got to get some early yards and get away from the shadow of their own goalposts. What every offense wants to do in this situation, get 2 first downs to help out with field position at the least.
First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
On second down, Cook. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Now Allen off the bootleg, rolling to his right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Oh, I saw this one with defensive eyes because even as he escaped the pocket and bought time, the coverage stayed tight. Nothing broke down. Throwing it away, that was his only option.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Allen. He's got his target. It's the tight end, Knox. A couple of first downs as the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. From just shy of midfield, Allen. This is caught at the 20. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. This clearly the final play of the half, but no field goal attempt. They're going for it with 3 seconds remaining.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure's good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
The kick by Bass is good, and that will do it for this first half. So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. Taking it about the one. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest. But now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're alluding to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. To the air, Allen. Dancing to his left. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be out right at the 35. Calling a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty. He was out there waving his arms. When you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen being chased out left. Going deep for Diggs, and that is caught. Touchdown, Buffalo. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. but sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. Here's the Bills' kickoff unit out as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You can say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
Sets up to pass it. Throw left side here, complete to the tight end, Gesicki. Here's second and seven now from the 28. Now whistles and a flag, and I believe a Dolphin got going a little early. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Off of play action, Tagovailoa. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill. And now Sean McDermott is going to throw out the challenge flag. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. A handoff running left is Mostert. That's a pretty strong running there as he'll take this across the 50 and down to the 44.
Here we go.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 44-yard line. And he'll send the tight end in motion here. Once again, it's Mostert. 106 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in this divisional round matchup.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
And he stopped after a gain of one. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll try and run here with Mostert. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to... Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. They'll try it now with Mostert. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. It'll be a pickup of four, and the Dolphins have a first down. Thought they might throw the football with a little chunk that they had remaining on fourth down, but they ran it, they got it.
And the reason they were able to get it done, he ran that play with conviction, didn't he? Understood he would get a little bit of help from his friends up front, but it was really on him to go ahead and make the power move and get it done, and that he did.
To the 27-yard line.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
38.
On second down, Mostert down right around the 25.
He may be a bit undersized compared to the modern-day NFL defensive tackle, but what he lacks in size, he definitely makes up for in his ability to make tackles in the run game as well.
Okay. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. And they're going to move it down inside the 25.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Kick is good, and the Dolphins will add on to their lead. So 3 points, response there to that opening touchdown this third quarter.
And that's an important three, both in terms of adding to your lead, but also letting the other guys know you're not going to just come out in the second half and take over.
Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. Very short kick taken right at the 20. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've gotten pretty revved up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, play at the same tempo and the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one.
Finding space at the 40. A big play here for Buffalo, 44 yards.
We have seen big plays from both quarterbacks throughout this game, and there's another one right there. Going back and forth, almost like two excellent guitar soloists trying to top each other with each additional play.
Allen now on first down. He'll get this out wide to Singletary. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's second down.
Now, that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, on maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
To throw again on second down. Allen. Works right side into the hands of the tight end, Knox. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 22 yards there, a first down. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. And again, it's Allen. And it's caught. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Singletary is in. Touchdown, Bills. He finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
An extra point by Bass, up and good.
And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded just outside the goal line. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And this has been a tight game to this point. Of course, they usually are at this juncture of the playoffs. But with the lead and the football, the clock right now, their friend, as they try to book their spot in the conference championship next Sunday. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Taron Johnson made the stop. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Second down. Here's Mostert again.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. The Dolphins on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 5. The man in motion left here, Johnson. Tua going to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he's as fine with that incompletion as a quarterback can be, in all honesty. He avoided his first sack of the game, and he did have a chance of connecting for yardage, just unable to on that throw.
Fielded just inside the 20. A well-hit ball there. 50 yards on the punt. 3 on the return, and the Bills will take over the football with a 1st and 10. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive, and this could be the defining moment of their season. All hyperbole aside, you're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round, and they need to come up with something as they get this drive started. The first play of the drive there is incomplete.
And next time, Brandon, I think you might want to consider running it, because those defensive backs, they were plastered to the receivers, and they weren't letting up as that play went on.
So after the incompletion, 2nd and 10 from the 22. Throwing now is Allen. Going deep for Diggs. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Here's Allen to throw it. Eluding the pressure right. Going deep for Diggs. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Well, I think we were both wondering if we were going to see them try and push it deep downfield, facing a one-possession deficit late, and they certainly didn't disappoint. They gave it an effort.
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. Here's Brett Kern now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Fair catch taken just across midfield, maybe by a yard or two. It's just a 30-yard punt that time, no return. And it'll be Dolphin football. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Now, the previous drive, they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well. They'll overall be happy with what they've seen.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
Check you. Hey, check you.
Again, they'll run it with Mostert. He'll get only a couple down to the 44. And that's on Austin Jackson, first-round pick in 2020.
Let's go.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Here's a handoff to Mostert running left. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. On the sideline, did he keep his feet in bounds? They say yes. Great job, both feet in, first down. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards.
Now that's a big pickup right there. So often we focus on how the quarterback's faking up play action. How about everyone being in on the deal and picking it up?
Second, third levels, you could see them trying to recover. They bit. Worked out offensively.
Here we go.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Up the middle they go with Mostert. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL. And he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time. So make sure you get in shape.
Ready?
Second down, here's Mostert again. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. On the handoff, this is Mostert. And his bid for the first down coming up short as he's tackled at the 25.
They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive could take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
So a big one coming now for Jason Sanders. This to make it a two-score game. Sanders' kick is good, and the Dolphins will add on their lead. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down two scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen buying time to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, sometimes the defense just beats you. Great coverage from the secondary, all of them in the proper position. So instead of trying to throw into tight coverage, he found a way to throw it away and come back and try again the next down.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Allen. Flush to his right. And that is caught. It's Davis. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. Diggs in motion left. Here's Allen on first and 10. He'll air this one out deep for Davis. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Diggs in motion left. To throw on second and 10. Allen. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one we're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
On play action, Allen. And he is going to be taken down. They got him. As that is going to take us to the two-minute warning.
Come on, come on, come on.
this one. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Dolphins get the football in great field position.
Ready?
Game in hand. The offense takes the knee.
Ready.
Victory very likely now for the Dolphins as they take a knee here. We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. They go to a knee here, and with that, it's on to the AFC title game. So with that knee, they take care of business in the divisional round. They'll be back here at home next weekend. One more hurdle to get to the big show.
The good feelings, they just keep coming. They get to ride that wave for at least one more week because they have their big prize in their eyes, and that's getting into the Super Bowl. But they have to win next week after winning this one.
Secured a spot in the conference championship, and now you can start to smell it at this point in the season, can't you?
You really can, because the focus has been one game at a time, not looking ahead. But when you get to the conference championship game and you know you're there, the Super Bowl does loom in the future.
My Brooklyn, go see Shy Rock, Southside, C12, 9-11, grrr, today, Riasi, we still outside. Mine on the wrenches, hard in the trenches. You can't throw dirt on the underground, we thrive in it. Ghana boys stocks on the rise, Charlie, this flex, no day ready. See, we went on the ride, nobody wait, we the ones who started with it. Translation, Yanya to buy, Yanya Yanya hits. This goes so hard, even the ops go with it, That's how you know we lit. Grrr,
gemstones from the dust, big dog with the leash, where's the love in the streets, put my heart on the beat, see the blood on my sheets, yeah, when me ready, me hit it heavy, I zoom out the pride of my people already, them I see early, me I'm just sharing my journey, I'm thankful the people they hear me, tribe of Joseph, I'm ahead of the bunch, P5, I was starving for months, a running cut scene, both of my pockets, me need my DNA, baby for lunch, but we call me a star before BBC, don't take a lot to get rid of me, me and them look at the same. Me and them no get the same. Why they don't know who the name is? They say I move like I'm nameless. Cause I only come for the money bags and I don't really wanna be famous. Yeah.
Legacy, we going crazy. We at the top and we never gonna stop. Hop in a ghost, I'ma get swayzy. I just got off of the jet and I cry. My I win and I humbly a lot. I be on go cause I come from the shot. I'm shooting back, I ain't ducking no shots. Got power like Samson, I cut off the locks. Shirek, Tema, in a cut like I'm Fredo Santana. Uju Bant and I hop in the Bama, the world is mine. I'm Tony Montana, I'm Pelican Fly. Diamonds on me cause I'm rapping a rock. I'ma go hard, I ain't killing them soft. I'm up in the hills, I feel like I'm Lauren, you ready or not?